Welcome back from that break, Munange. So apparently, Kayihura is one of the least popular people in the Muslim community. Sheikh Muzata has even actually encouraged all Muslims to go to hardwares and they buy pangas. When they see a police person, they get off his head. I like Sheikh Muzata. But for once, I'll be on the side of the police. So this is what happened. Kale Kayihura ordered a raid. Okay, he's not calling it a raid because that's a harsh word. But that's what happened. They raided a mosque, and apparently it's because they had gotten a tip, and they were saying that Simanyi, they have a lead in connection with the killing of Major Sheikh Chigundu. Hey, apparently some weapons were hidden in a mosque. So Bambe, he went there. Then the Muslims, Banange, they opened up a battle. And yeah, they were saying that Kayihura is trying to brand them as terrorists. The Tablik Muslims in Uganda. That Kayihura is just attempting to, he's trying to paint them as terrorists. First of all, you guys are watching too much TV. Here in Uganda, there's nothing like terrorism. Yes, it was there, but it's not like the way it is in the United States, where people use it as political talking points. Here in Uganda, if anything, we are jealous of Muslims, man. You Muslims, you enjoy a lot of sex, man, legally. A Muslim, have you seen what SK is doing? He lines up socialites. Leila, Vivian, Simanyu, Wato. They are saying, because that's your right. So here in Uganda, Muslims, they are normal. So when you try to say that Kayihura is trying to brand you as terrorists, we don't get it, man. That's just a far-fetched point. And I think that just being a place of worship does not mean that a mosque should not be raided. Here in Uganda, places of worship, Munange, these days, they turned. Imagine right now if you went and went to I cannot cite a name. But imagine you go to some of these Mafere churches and you go there, inside there. Imagine all that you can uncover. Imagine if you took there like an HIV test to that church and you say that before you enter this church, we shall test your blood. That church for that day, there will only be the pastor and like two ushers. Let me tell you something. Just because someone... Let me tell you, I'm not just saying that you're going to excuse all Muslims. Not all Muslims are holy. I know all of you think that Muslims are on the same page, that all Muslims are holy, that all Muslims deserve to be treated with respect. Simanyi, you're encroaching on a holy place. Not all Muslims are holy. Bebe Okul posted thighs of Zuena during Ramadan. That's all of your Muslims there on the list. People go to Mecca. When they come from Mecca, 9 months after that, they have children in Saudi Arabia. So don't lie to us, my friend. Just because it's a mosque, don't lie. You speak for yourself. You say that for you, you're holy. We know Muslims, my friend. We know Muslims. That one, Bad Blacks, is a Muslim also. Apparently, she's taking pictures with pastors. Isn't that like a crime in the Muslims? Relax. Just because you're holy, just because you feel passionate about your religion, does not mean that inside that religion, we can't have people who are not doing the right thing. Ask our locally. They have a person called Kakande. They can't understand him. When Balokoye are going to heal someone, they go pray for him. For him, he just looks at you, he does a somersault, he does push-ups, and you get healed. Up to now, it's a puzzle. No one knows how he does it. He's there. So you cannot really say that you're going to understand everyone in your religion. No, you can't understand that. One day I saw Kakande healing someone. I was like, is this Olympics? Are we watching the gymnastics session or what, man? The dude just looks at you, man. Before you know that, he has done a backflip. Again, looks at you like this. The demon has already gone. He does a somersault. Again, looks at you like this, man. Jesus Christ, what is he doing? So apparently there's some man with a very big beard. He wants to kill Kayihura, you know? And he's saying that Kayihura is trying to paint the Tablik Muslims as terrorists. Me, I think it's laughable. Because in Uganda, the terrorist thing, that whole thing that you sit on a bus, in Pioneer bus, and when you see a Muslim, you go out, that's non-existent here in Uganda. Do you think that's true? You really think here in Uganda, we are trying to demonize Muslims? Is that a thing?
I'm actually more scared of Christians.
Yeah.
Christians go there, you go to the place and you say, I have an ulcer, pray for me.
Yeah.
And they start spraying doom in your head.
But you see, that's the thing. To be honest with you, at first I used to be scared of the Christian churches. Not all Christian churches, some of them I think are true. But most of these born-again churches, I now admire them. They have an excellent business strategy. Mm-hmm. I mean, think about it. Someone just goes and buys a jerrycan of just 2,500. He goes to a swamp. He gets water for free. He boils this water. He puts it in the jerrycan of 2,500. He has invested 2,500. He goes in a church and he sprinkles holy water. And for everyone who he sprinkles holy water on, you leave 50k note. So imagine, it's not even per liter, it's per sprinkle. How many sprinkles can come from 3 liters of a jerrycan?
And this is the person who you went to had boiled the water.
He's
pouring the water on you.
Landing in your mouth. Some of these churches, they are helping people relieve stress, like Watoto. Watoto is like a hangout center now. Seriously?
Name in particular church.
Sure, we're not attacking. No. These are our people.
I'm not going to go. If I attend the church.
No, we're not attacking the pastor.
Have you heard
of we're not attacking the pastor. We're attacking some of our friends we have seen go there because we know their lifestyle. They tell us they have gone to get laid.
And this is terrorism now. Mm. This is terrorism. Because terrorism is the act of using terror to put forth an agenda, to establish your power.
Yeah.
You make people frightened of how powerful you can be.
Mm.
Like, for example, someone comes and says that if you're members of this church, you're going to obey me. If you don't obey me, I will bring you in front of this church and you will tell the whole congregation what you did. Come to in front of the pastor and say, I had unlawful canon knowledge, fornicated with sister so-and-so seven times.
Why are you saying that? Why are you using complicated terms? You just say, I banged someone.
Some of our viewers might not understand such obscene words as rape.
Someone who can understand the word canon knowledge can understand bang.
Okay. Even those who can't understand,
Had
sex.
Yeah.
Had sexual had knowledge banging
took place between you and you tell the whole church how many times we did it. Then you bring the girl up here and she tells everybody whether she enjoyed, how good you were, lousy or not.
That's
and
a dope church.
No, that church like that is terrorism.
What?
Because everyone who hears that says, I had better not have sex with any of the girls in this church.
Because
they find out, I will also be on stage and they are going to, and I'll have to be.
But that's Kalango. Why would you be afraid of that? Because that's Kalango. Apparently, if you're good, babes are going to keep coming.
So now, what if there are two of you who had sex with the same man? One of them is. And now you have. That's how you find out.
It's brotherly love. God teaches us to not call.
And brother Joseph.
Yeah. It's brotherly love. And sister Irene.
Yes.
It's a fellowship. But seriously, you know, let's look at this whole thing from the angle of our Muslims trying to counter efforts of national security. Should a place of worship, okay, let's just try to leave the Muslims. Should a place of worship be off the radar, be a no-go area for law enforcement?
Well, I wouldn't know because I myself am not a religious person. As you know,
you're an atheist.
I'm a pagan.
No, you're an atheist.
No, I'm not. I believe God is there. I just.
But you believe he's like the rest of us. You think he's on the same level like us?
No.
Like he earns a salary?
I am hiding from him.
Why?
Because I've done something.
You know, there's a woman who told me. There's an American woman who told me that she believes that Jesus was around. But she believed that Jesus was just like a good speaker. Like Jesus was like Tamale Mirundi.
Those are the people. Those are the people that I like. Because I believe that God is more concerned with them, so he's not going to judge me. He's going to first deal with it. Like on the day of judgment, I think that my problems will come on the day after the day of judgment. Because they'll deal with those people first. What I think Kayihura should do is stop deceiving us and diverting us with these other issues.
Mm.
Kayihura should focus on what is really going on in this Ugandan society of ours. Go to that church and find out why people are spraying doom on other people's heads.
But that's a good thing. Maybe
doom on me.
As you can see, we have failed to solve this also. But hopefully next year we shall come back with some more good information. And before we go, please, Bambi, let us leave you with some of the best highlights from the shows that we have had this year. This is apparently our 14th episode. Bye. We leave you now with some of our best moments on this show. Joining us right now on the hot seat is Cats.
Cats. Uganda. Kume! All along you had one ball, just one ball. A woman beat you and you couldn't do anything about it.
Wow, man, just try to be a perfect gentle dwarf. You know what I mean?
Gentle dwarf? What do you mean gentle dwarf?
Gentle dwarf. Okay, it's the simple term to mean gentleman, for us short people. You get what I'm saying, eh?
Kalad!
Fee, man, you will have your turn now, come on.
If you're not taking me seriously, then let me talk to the audience. We want our rights. These people are equal.
No,
you know,
wait, you don't talk to my audience.
We always have to get the same rights. We are also people. You know,
cut
we want to be here. You know,
cut
I don't
his
want.
Mic off. Shut the hell up. Parents out there, you see, how sad does this look? How miserable does this look? You think it's bad to see your kids being tear gassed? To see them being caned by policemen? This is so much worse. Don't pay school fees for such children, parents. Let them dig. Thank you.
The only thing actually that I feel bad actually about this whole thing with the AFCON is that we had to wait for 39 years to say that we qualified for something. I think that we as Ugandans, we are not tapping into our potential. There are very many things that we could tap into and we win the competitions. Think about it. Like, if we had like an African booze competition, which country can beat Uganda? Hey, we can drink. No, I'm telling you, we can drink. I think you need to understand what I'm saying. Ugandans, we can drink.
Can you drink a drunk beer? You not drink a drunk beer.
That's why a hangover is always like way up there. Like, no, you will never go in any country and you see people as hangover as Ugandans.
Now, away from that, recently, Arsenal played with a team called PSG, Paris Saint-Germain, and then somewhere, somehow, Arsenal didn't get to win the game because they were looking for a win. So PSG, I think here it came in as a way to deter Arsenal from its mission. The word Arsenal has another name. Actually, Arsenal is the Gunners. So PSG could stand for properly screwed Gunners. And when I look at the word Arsenal, these guys were really so good in the beginning, but now they're amazing, real soccer entertainers. Now automatically allows it.
Yes, I love you. Just like they were supposed to be holy. You go to all clubs. They travel all the way from Amsterdam, Belgium, Hong Kong, Croatia. Now in Uganda, you have Katemba. Why would a Ugandan be in Croatia? Oh, what do you know there? What are you doing there? Uganda comedian Kapari is going to perform in Turkey. Everybody, welcome back home. We know you have been there for 10 years. The only thing you've gotten is an accent.
My plans to be in the United States wasn't to live in the United States. You know what I mean? Oh my God, Uganda has got beautiful women. You know what I mean? You see, you gotta know.
Abaye bagende di wabweru, ne bakwana abazungu, ne bazala ba Obama, mwabana Uganda, you go there. The only thing you come back is go wana. Now sometimes you need to get ashamed. I don't know what is happening to Basama these days. Think over what do they eat out there? Whatever they have in the cereal, they are like broiler chicken. You know, these breeds of chicken which they groom just for eating. They are at governor. You know that red carpet at governor? Most they're always like five people. But the Abasama, they are fat. So they can be like only one at a time. They come from UK, they have eaten all that illegal immigrant food, the government subsidies. And they're here threatening us that they have money. Muribavu, we look at, you're poor. Don't show up on us. Semwanga, what happened? Semwanga is totally broke. Even his color turned back to black. He had bleached, he's light skinned, but 2016 has been one hell of a year. You know when you lose money and you lose also skin color and pigment, now you're poor. You're the definition of broke.